Whether we are representing our neighbors in rural, urban, or suburban Pennsylvania, this is an issue that has touched everyone. This is not the first time that something like this, so tragic and awful, has occurred. I was in the 12th grade, finishing high school in 1999 when Columbine happened. And at that time frame, a school shooting was an anomaly. It was an uproar, an outrage. It was, how could this happen? What could have occurred? What could have brought this type of violence to a school? It was something we couldn't fathom or understand. But you fast forward and get to 2022, and we see headlines all the time that violence is surging, particularly gun violence. And here, as lawmakers, we have the responsibility to do something. And if Republicans have been in control for 25 of the last 27 years and have done nothing with their ability to call up bills, to bring bills out of a committee, to ensure that there's enough votes to get a bill sent to the Senate and to the governor's desk, they have failed us, and they are complicit in this outrageous gun violence. It is absolutely out of control, and it is something that we implore them, as we return to session shortly hereafter, to come to the table and let's address this. We must address it. There is not one district out of 203 that has not been affected. Whether we're talking about suicide or homicide, this has been happening everywhere in this Commonwealth, and enough is absolutely enough. My colleagues have said it best. Thoughts and prayers are not enough. They're not sufficient. We have work to do.